Hello and welcome. Thanks for being with us. You're watching our special show on Mirror Now Inspire India, where we bring to you and feature Good Samaritans and salute these individuals who are working tirelessly, relentlessly for all those who are in need of help at this time when there is an unprecedented crisis amidst all of us. These are ordinary individuals who have risen to the occasion at this point, helping out all those underprivileged people, all those in need of basic assistance, reaching out to all of them at this point. On our show, we're bringing to you three such individuals, and it's my honor to tell you about the work that they have been doing in the state of Maharashtra, which, remember, has recorded one of the highest cases of coronavirus. On the show, let me introduce to you our first guest, who is Shailesh Mishra, who's a social worker, who started this initiative, which is called Mission Help Hungry. Now, this initiative looks at ensuring that all the people who are in need of assistance, especially the underprivileged, the daily wages, the migrants who are the worst affected at this point, do not go hungry. In fact, this initiative and Shailesh's team also ensures that they distribute ration to the people. Not just that, they're also looking after the medical supplies and they ensure doorstep delivery of the medical supplies to those in need. My second guest on the show, Ovesh Hira, who's also a social worker and who's with the initiative of KGN Nias Committee in Mumbai. And this initiative now goes ahead to also ensure that nobody sleeps hungry in the city of Mumbai. They're reaching out to the needy. They're reaching out to the homeless who, remember, have no source of livelihood and they have no income. Now, KGN Nias Committee, in fact, and his team, in fact, set up a community kitchen as well to help all those in need of this crisis. My third guest, Paritosh Pant, who's from the Feeding From Far, another initiative which also takes care of the underprivileged and the needy and the homeless who, remember, right now are the worst affected because of this crisis. They have also set up a community kitchen and their volunteers ensure that over 200 volunteers are helping and distributing to as many people as possible. I welcome you all on the show and we salute the kind of work that all of you are doing at this time. This is an unprecedented crisis like we have never seen before. Let me begin by going to Shailesh Mishra first. Shailesh, many thanks for joining us and speaking to us. So first of all, help us understand how this initiative came into existence, what inspired you to start with this. And this is important because we are talking about reaching out to the daily wagers who've been worst affected, reaching out to the migrant population who have been worst affected by this crisis. Tell us about your operation.
First of all, namaste to everybody. We started this initiative at Mira Road, Mira Bhayandar. And the initiative is about, we have four or five people in the group. We found our maid, our driver, our people on the slum. We found them not having food and also there were shortage of the funds because salaries are not paid in time. They could not go to work and they are daily wages like electrician, plumber. We as a group of an advocate, a health professional, a social worker, we all came together. We took out some money and we thought let's do some, provide them 15 days ration because cooked food, we thought it is a perishable item, but ration at least we can provide them so they're independent, they can cook. So this food is provided.
Yes, sir, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Hello. Got disconnected.
Mr. Shailesh, we can hear you. Please go ahead.
So we came together and we thought we will provide ration to people, 15 days ration, so they can cook on their own. We wanted to make them independent, not dependent on us. So we went to the street, we went to the slums. We also identify people who actually are in need. So also then we got a request from people living in the building, middle class people. We thought it's our initiative, government is doing something. What as a citizen we should do? So we, it's a small work for the nation.
Uh, Mr. Shailesh, this is a very noble initiative that you started, and you made sure that you're reaching out to all those people by giving them dry ration at this point. Also, help us understand your distribution network, because you're not only giving out ration, you're also ensuring that it reaches to as many people as possible. You're also ensuring that you're supplying medical essentials to everybody at the doorstep. How does this entire network work?
So we, as we said, we have a group of people. We have distributed our phone number in different WhatsApp channel and social media. We get a request from people from as far as Virar, Bhosar and Palghar. Somebody is stuck in Mira Bhayandar, somebody is stuck in Palghar. So they send us the request about medicine, about vegetable, about ration. So we also try to identify, call the people, or one of the volunteer goes and visits the place, and then we provide the ration to them. We also have to ensure that it goes to the right people and people not hoarding ration, because there are some cases that people have started hoarding ration. We have to identify, we have to be very careful, because people are also giving some funds, and it is a work to make them independent, and it's a 15-day ration. So I don't know how long the lockdown is going to happen, but we are trying to provide as much we can. And we also identify street people living on the street. We also identify Adivasi people. We are trying to help people as much we can.
Absolutely. Shailesh, request you to stay with us at this point. And the way you've been talking to us about the operation and how you're reaching out to people simply using WhatsApp to identify these people, it's extremely important. And your contribution is absolutely significant. Stay with us. Let me also bring in our second guest, Ovesh Hira, who's part of the KGN Niaz Committee. Now, this is a group which was started by some of the friends who were living in the Dudhwala Housing Society in the Mumbai Central area. Ovesh, tell us about your initiative. And it is very important here to note that you've widened your entire scope during this time of the lockdown, which is extremely crucial. Tell us about this initiative and what prompted you to start this community kitchen, and how has been the response?
Yeah, hello to everybody. This I want to say that on 20th of March, when our Chief Minister, Mr. Uddhav Thackerayji, announced that there will be lockdown from 21st, and so the very same evening, we are a group of friends, about 15 people in our society, who formed this KGN Niaz committee. So we decided that since the lockdown is going to happen and there are many daily wage earners and needy people, and as we are close to Mumbai Central Station also, many of these people who cannot catch the trains like this, so we must need to help them. So we form a fund, we contributed ourselves, and then we started this. Initially, we started from 200 packets, but we saw that it's not enough. So it started to grow. And now it's up to about 3,000 packets per day. That is about around 1,500 in the afternoon and 1,500 in the evening. And then when we started contributing, then through our friends, then friends of friends, all started to chip in when they saw this work is good. And that's how we started to grow. And now we are up to 3,000 people per day. And this also helps.
Ovesh, also when you decided to start a community kitchen.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And that's important, yes. Because when you started this initiative of getting 2 to 3 cooks to set up a community kitchen in your society, what were the big challenges before you? Because you were trying to aim to reach out to a lot of people. So what were the initial challenges before you at that point?
Challenges first was that even the cooks were afraid to come, and then we need to provide them with shelter and for their accommodation and everything, and to source in the grains and everything, because in the beginning days there was lots of people in everywhere for buying all this and everything. Nah? So through our sources, we start to gather the things and started to means also the utensils big. We don't have such utensils in the houses, so we arrange that everything, and then we found a place where to cook this, and must also according to the social distancing and hygiene, everything had to be taken care of. So slowly we started to understand this, and it became smoothly.
Uh, All right. On that note, let me also go across to Shailesh Mishra, who's still with us. Shailesh, this is also an initiative that you've been looking at. Your aim is to right now reach to as many people as possible. So far, how many people have you been able to reach? Which are the areas right now that you've been getting maximum response from and you've been going out to reach out to these people in these areas?
So, at presently, we are concentrating on Mira Bhayandar Municipal Corporation area. But we also getting requests from Virar, Vasai, Nalasopara. There we can't reach, but we have our sources. We forward the contact. At present, our reach is to Mira Bhayandar Municipal Corporation, which has around 14 lakhs people. And we try to reach out to people and find out what is the need. And also, we have provided ration to around 250 families, which includes 4% of the family. We have reached out to two orphanage. We have also reached out to some Adivasi people. We have reached out to senior citizens who are living alone. And we are trying to help people in this municipality area. So if you have any contact in Mira Bhayandar Municipal Corporation area, please let us know. We'll be very happy to help. And I also want to mention that Municipal Commissioner Chandrakant Dange and police are helping us in this work. And we also want to come ahead, and I request to everybody to come ahead and help the government to tackle this situation. And we all together can fight corona. Hum jeetenge ek din.
Absolutely. And that's a very beautiful and an inspiring message, Shailesh, that you've given to all of us. And I'm sure viewers who are watching us are definitely inspired by the work that you're doing and your team is doing right now to reach out to all those people. Remember, these are people who are in absolute need of basic essentials, and your team and you have facilitated and ensured that they do not go home or they do not sleep hungry. Many thanks, Shailesh, for joining us and giving us your story on how you started this. It will definitely inspire a lot of people who are watching us. Thank you so much for joining us. Let me go across to Ovesh Hira, who's still with us. Ovesh, you spoke about the difficulties that were there, but right now, since day one of the lockdown, you've been able to ease out this entire network. Tell us about your team who are working with you. How do you identify the areas? Which are the areas, in fact, you are looking at, and the number of people who you've been able to reach out to?
Yeah, initially, I said that we started with 200 people. But then when people came to know that we are distributing food packets, so from different areas, like we started from Mumbai Central, but people from Sivri, from Wadala, from even from Chembur, they came to know and they started to come here. So we made a list and decided according to that how many packets we need to give to which people, to which area. So this started growing. And each session, like we have two sessions, one in the afternoon, one in the evening. So each session we are now distributing 1,500 packets. First, we decided to directly give the grains, but then when we realized that all the people don't have kitchen, they don't even have homes, and they are stranded people and staying on the roads, so even if we give them grains, they won't be able to cook it. So we ourselves are doing this and started to distribute.
And do you also use any kind of, are you using social media to perhaps get more volunteers? What has been the response to that? Are more people joining this cause at this point? The common public who are looking at the work that you're doing, are you receiving more response from the common people now?
Yeah, we are response like we are receiving to our friends and friends of friends. When they come to know of this cause, they start to donate us. But as far as the volunteer is concerned, our society is a big society of more than 200 residences. So we are in-house, we have lots of volunteers who are helping us and doing this good.
And also in terms of spreading awareness, I'm sure this entire initiative is also aimed at spreading awareness. How are you educating the people, especially those who are part of this group? You're also reaching out to a lot of people. What is the kind of awareness that you're creating amongst them?
Yeah, the awareness that we are telling them that when you are taking these packets, you must not see who the people, who is this, who is from where, or well, whoever is coming, you should give them no. Must not ask any question, must not see their faces also, just directly whoever's coming in the line, just see that social distancing is being followed and you start to give them, and without asking anything and without doing any discrimination or anything.
All All right, Ovish, request you to stay with us at this point. That's a very beautiful initiative that you shared with us, and we would like to speak to you more about it. We're just going to be slipping into a very short break. We'll be back and we'll come back to talking to you about the other things and how you've been able to facilitate this entire initiative and reach out to a large number of people. Ovish, stay with us. We're going to be slipping into a very short break. Inspire India, and we're bringing to you so stories of individuals who are currently at this point reaching out to hundreds and thousands of people who are in need of basic essentials. My third guest on this show who's joining us right now, Paritosh Pant from Feeding From Far, an initiative which is also looking at ensuring that people, the needy people, the underprivileged people, do not sleep hungry. Now, this initiative also looks at providing cooked meals to all those in need. So far, this initiative has been able to reach out at least 3,500 people daily with the help of the food that has been cooked in the community kitchen. Paritosh, many thanks for joining us, and it's a beautiful initiative and the noble cause of everyone trying to reach out to those and ensuring that they do not sleep hungry. Tell us about your initiative and the fact that the food, you've been able to reach out to at least 3,500 people daily and the food which is being prepared in a community kitchen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Mira, now for giving us this opportunity to reach out about our campaign. Just to correct, since the last 2 days, we've actually increased our capacity because our fundraiser campaign went viral. So now we're reaching out to 5,000 families daily, feeding them lunch and dinner. So we're doing 10,000 cooked meals every day.
Okay, also, Paritosh, tell us about the operation. How do you go about it? It's a big network that we're looking at. You're, of course, reaching out to a lot of people. Which are the areas where you're able to reach out to these people?
So internally, the whole of... So we're based out of Govandi only. This is a community kitchen inside Govandi. How we're reaching out is that we have 40 different team members who are all in pockets or the whole of Govandi. All right. And they are actually individuals who are doing an individual effort themselves by creating kitchens for, let's say, about 100, 200 meals. But they didn't have the infrastructure. They didn't have the funds to sustain it. But they knew the exact beneficiaries in their area. So we just came inside, figured out operations. We have actually no credit here. It's absolutely the on-ground team, the on-ground community who's really putting this together. The operation is very simple. We have a security team that guards the kitchen area, because in slum areas, people tend to start flooding the area, and we don't want that to happen. It's a lockdown situation. We have a packaging team that comes exactly during the lunch and the dinner time when the food is ready. They can't enter the premises because there's a bouncer standing there with the soap with them, and he just puts like soap in everyone's hand, so they have to wash their hands before coming inside. There's a kitchen team that is separate. They are there throughout. They're also living right near the kitchen area so that they don't have to venture out throughout. They're wearing the protective gear that is needed. So that is how we're doing. We did a lot of sensitization programs on ground, made them aware about this is not just a relief program. This is a very, very intense relief program where with the intentions of actually doing good to the people, it's very important for you guys to be clean, because you have to deliver food. You don't have to deliver corona with the food.
Absolutely. That's a beautiful message, that you have to deliver food. You don't have to deliver corona with the food. So you're also, in a way, educating and creating awareness through your initiative to all the people that you're reaching out. But also, Paritosh, very quickly, help us understand about the funds that you've been able to raise for this cause as well. In addition to serving the people with food, you're also raising the funds for this cause as well. Tell us about this and the kind of response you have received so far.
Sure. So when I posted on Facebook saying that, hey, I really want to do something like this, I want to put something together, I think I can. My school friend Pooja Reddy, she helped me out. She said, hey, let's do this. She's actually a high court lawyer. And that's it. We both came together. We put this program together. For the first phase, we wanted funds to implement the program. And that completely came through like friends and family. It came through, like, Pooja is a lawyer. She has a good lawyer fraternity. So initially, customs, excise, service, tax, appeal, that's the SESTAT, they came together. We first pooled for our first phase 20 lakh rupees. And we started with, let's say, about 2,000 meals lunch and 2,000 meal dinner, just so that we can implement this program and we have like a system to go out and then raise funds. Further, another school friend of mine came and he said, hey, let me come and document this on ground because we need to make a video. We want to prove the people that, you know, we have a system on ground. All we need is your good wishes and your funds. Stay at home, but give us funds. We're really doing the right thing. That's it. After that, we launched our fundraising campaign. And actually, since today morning, we've already raised 19 lakhs in less than 4 days. It's going very well. So that's how we're raising funds. We're completely crowdsourcing. We're talking to different companies. We're talking to CSR initiatives. We're talking to other individuals, other NGOs. Rotary Club of Bombay, Powai, has come together as community partners. We've got Earth Angels Welfare Foundation on ground who's helping us with logistics, who's helping us with supplies, sourcing that. But most importantly, we have Ekta Navjavan Committee, who's in Govandi, handling the volunteers. It's completely Ekta guys who are the volunteers, who are the ones we've trained, and they're the ones actually going and reaching out to the beneficiaries.
All right, Paritosh, stay with us. Quickly taking one final word from Ovesh, who's still with us. Ovesh, what is the message that you want to give out to people? It is the work of you, all of you, who is essentially inspiring a lot of people at this point to also contribute. So what is the message that you want to give to the people at this point, especially at these unprecedented crisis hour?
Yeah, the message I want to give is that this is the time. Like we see the benefits in our businesses, then we must also see the benefit for our afterlife in this opportunity. Like, this is an opportunity for us to help the poor, and also this will be good for us in the long term, in the future, for our children, for everyone. So this is a very good investment for generations to come if we contribute now, because this is the best time and the most needed time for them.
All right, Ovesh and Paritosh, many thanks for speaking to us. Extremely inspiring initiatives that has been taken up by both of you. And we hope many others follow suit in trying to help all those in need at this time. Many thanks for joining us. And with that, it's a wrap on this edition of Inspire India. We'll be back with another edition tomorrow. Till then, stay safe and keep watching Mirror Now.